Every day, 140 buses and vans leave the Daytona and Yale transit facilities. 100 maintenance personnel, including mechanics, electronic technicians, paint and body workers, and vehicle servicers, work at these facilities. The skilled labor force can do anything from changing oil to changing a tire, rebuilding an engine or a transmission, to completely painting a vehicle. Maintenance staff work nearly around the clock to ensure that all buses and vans are serviced, cleaned, fueled, and ready to provide safe, reliable, and affordable transportation for our passengers. I'm ABQ Ride Director Bruce Rizzeri. Join me as we take a behind-the-scenes look at a day in the life of an ABQ Ride mechanic.
I'm Ruben Manero. I'm a mechanic technician. I've been here for 14 and a half years. I started down at Yale, at the Yale shop. That's the only shop we had back then. And now, 4.5 years ago, we opened up this facility up here. I get my coffee ready in the morning. Of course, this is before I clock in, of course. We gotta make sure all these vehicles are up and running and, you know, just get prepped for the day. It's a typical day. Here we work 4 10-hour days. I'll come in at 6 o'clock. Most of the crew comes in at 6 o'clock. There's 2 people each day that come in at 4 o'clock a.m. to get the vehicles running and stuff and make sure they're up to par. At any given time, you could have probably 5 or 6 buses in the shop at a time. Like I say, the AM crew comes in at 4. My Thursday happens to be my early day, which I come in at 4 and start the buses and vans and make sure everything's up to par.
That's what we gotta do for every bus in the morning. Wait till the start light goes off, just wait. Each and every bus till it goes to the system, open, wakes up the computers, because the computers are still asleep. Start it up, and we don't have a starter on it. What turns it is actually the transmission part of it. With the battery power, it's what actually turns the bus and starts the engine.
Sometimes at 4 o'clock, I enjoy working at 4 o'clock in the morning. A lot of people say, how can you do that? Get up so early and come. I enjoy being out here and dealing with the drivers that are out here, the bus drivers, van drivers. You associate with them. I enjoy all the people that work here. I mean, you're talking to the van drivers and you're knowing that you're keeping them going. You're keeping them in the vehicle that they're working in all day long. You know, instead of the driver going out there and starting their cold vehicle and okay, it's warming up, and then you get a call, hey, this vehicle doesn't run right. And then somebody else will call, then somebody else will call. You know, this way, if you have them started way ahead of time before they even get here, if you have a problem, you can swap out that vehicle before they even show up. And they don't even know they had a problem.
Okay.
If something's wrong, either they'll have what we call a blue card, and the driver will make notations that there's something wrong with this van or bus. There's wheels are squeaking or something. We'll bring it in and take a look at the brakes. You know, the brakes are soft. You know, the brakes and stuff, the suspension parts are a real important component that it's a safety issue. You know, we're dealing with public here. We have to make sure we have good running vehicles. And, you know, if we can keep them from breaking, I mean, that's our goal, to keep them from breaking before something happens. We'll come in and do safety checks. If a driver writes, like say, squeaky brakes, we'll look at the brakes and test drive it and jack it up and pull wheels off and look at the brakes and make sure that it's in good working order before it goes back out. And other times we do PMs, which is preventive maintenance. We'll do them at 3,000 mile intervals, and we'll just bring it in just to do a preventive maintenance check. We have a checklist that we go through on each preventive maintenance schedule list. We'll go through and check various components. We'll first and foremost, we do after safety, and that's what we look for first in a vehicle, is the safety issues. After we're done with the checkoff list, then we go through and start doing the write-ups that we came up with. like in this case, in each breaks, so that part of the write-up, he's doing that task. We call him task, that's maybe task number 5. So he'll log in on that task, he'll do his time on that task. If he runs into a problem with parts or something, availability, whatever, then he'll go on to another task and log into doing something else, like tightening the bumper or a muffler or whatever else might be wrong on the other task that he needs to do. He'll log in on that. So his time is logged in for each individual task. And at the end of the day, on our timesheet, we have to have 10 hours of work time on the timesheet. If you don't have 10 hours of work time on there, there's something wrong. Then we get written up or they'll dock us for it. Hey, there's something going on here. Why were you here for 10 hours, but yet you only did 9 hours of work? So every job that we do, we gotta log it down. We get audited. They go through and check the audit. Well, why are these guys here and they're only doing so much work? They're here for 10 hours. They're only doing 5 hours of work. There's something wrong. So we have to actually account for all the time that we are here. Clear. Each bus has 10 fuel tanks in it that holds 3,600 PSI in the whole system. So you make one mistake there and it's deadly. You know, you got to be very careful in this industry. And the same on any component. You put your hand in the wrong place when something's turning, these engines ain't going to stop just because your finger's in the way. You know, it's very difficult to do some of the stuff that we do here, but we have to learn it on the job. You know, there's no place that you could actually go and learn city bus mechanicking. I mean, a lot of these guys come in from different, you know, like automotive cars, and some are diesel mechanics, some are, you know, so a little bit of everybody come together. And if you don't know, you can ask the other guy, say, yeah, I worked on something like that last month. Hey, I did this, I did that, you know, and you just kind of work with each other. And the guys around here, they work with each other real well. There's a lot of talented mechanics here that work here. I mean, I don't know where else you can find any people like this. There's a lot of people here that have pride in their work, that, you know, enjoy working on this stuff here. And you know, and that's what it takes a lot of times to have a good running shop, to keep things going smoothly, is people that want to work here. It's not here just because it's a job, but you know, they also look in the background, we're doing this for the public. You're not doing it just for a paycheck. You're doing it for the public and to keep the public going. It takes a lot of want to be a mechanic, and then bus mechanic, they're far and few between. You know, that, you know, there's not everywhere. I mean, there are, you know, van mechanics that work on these and they take pride in their work.
Let's see, I need a lot of bone pull 102, so those are plenty thick. These are just replaced ones, they get too thin. When they're thick enough to machine, we machine them on the brake lid. Once they're too thin, then we gotta replace them. Ruben does the bigger brakes on the buses.
My typical day, I'll come in and either do a brake job, that which consists of turning the brake drums and turning the brake shoes to match. This here's the lift that we have to use for the hoist to hoist things back and forth. Save on the back. Gotta line this up on the hub. This is simulating being mounted on the bus. Part that's on the inside, right on the inside where the bid off of here is touching on the inside, is giving it a fresh finish on the inside of the drum. And that's the surface that the brake shoes are going to ride on. The brake shoes ride on that surface. When I'm done on this end, I'll set up the brake shoes on this end. I can't set them up yet because I'm not sure of the finish size on here. Once I'm done with the finish size, then I'll work off of my gauge here and give it a little bit more. That way I know I have the proper clearances when it goes on the bus. But after I make a full pass, then I'll slow the machine down. When it's got it cleaned up, I cut the biggest drum first. That way I make both of them match. Both sides of the two front wheels or two back wheels or two center wheels, they'll both of those on that same axle, they'll match one another. You can be within 20 thousandths, but when I send them out of this brake shop, I like to have them both equal. While the machine is doing its job, I'll go off and bead blast parts in this machine here, other brake components, or I'll go off to the shop and work on another bus. You can see the brake shoe on this far side in there. Here I gotta finish bead blasting it. I really can't pinpoint anything in particular. I enjoy doing the brakes. You know, I know that's a real critical component on the bus. I don't know if there's any one thing that I really enjoy the most. I enjoy working here all in general. Different days, you just get different stuff. Sometimes you get an accident. Sometimes you have to go out on the road. Somebody blows a transmission up or an engine or something. You got to block off traffic. You got to deal with the public. They're yelling and screaming, get that bus off the road, and this and that and the other. I mean, you can't, if you could get it off the road, you would. But it's broken. It's not like I can get behind it and push it or, you know. But we try to get it out of the traffic lanes, you know, as much as we could, and do it in a safe manner too. We'd rather be working on it in here, but sometimes it just happens. Things happen on cars, trucks, buses. You know, there's things that are not preventable that we come across. It's just wear and tear stuff a lot of times that, you know, when we try to stay on top of that on our PM inspections. So when we're doing PM inspections, that's our goal, is to find stuff before it breaks. And then that saves a road call from people getting, you know, on the way to work, and they get stopped on the way to work, and they got to wait for the next bus and stuff. We're trying to prevent all that stuff. And, you know, if people realize what all it takes back in here in the shop to take care of all that, there's a lot of hard work that goes into it, you know, not just by one or two people, it's the whole crew in general. This bus was a road call, it's an emergency road call. Gives you the name of the driver, the date, the problem, nature of trouble, overheating, and it tells you the location of the vehicle. This one happened to be on Central and in Central Bypass. And they send out a driver, they tell them what time to be there. Well, right now the bus was down, so they went to go get it. Now we're looking over that problem, overheating. We do everything in-house. If a van has a blown engine, something happens to the engine, we'll pull it apart here. We have mechanics here that take out engines and take out trannies, and there's guys here that'll build engines, they'll build transmissions. Same with the buses. You know, we have a couple rapid rides that had engines go, failure on the engines. On the Caterpillar engines on some of the rapid rides, and some guys come in and they'll take care of that. They'll take out the engine and take it apart. Another guy, we have a unit room, and the other guy will go in there and rebuild the engine, and when it's done, the other guys will get it back again. They'll put all the components back on it, the exterior part of the engine, and then they'll put it back in the bus. There's a lot of hidden stuff that people don't see, you know. They probably don't even think, well, they do their own brakes there. It's like, you know, Brake Masters or whatever, we do brakes here, okay. Now you go to the other side of the shop, we have a tire shop, this guy does tires. Right here, this guy's off, he works day shift. He does all the welding and fabricating in this shop here. He'll build whatever you want, somebody like that. And then you got a body shop further on down. He's making a repair on the doors here. I'm not sure, was this in a collision?
Broken window. Why, I don't know what happened to it.
Sometimes they get hit with rocks or something going down the freeway, a rock hits it or collision, whatever. Mike is one of the guys that takes care of some of the body work around here. Got several lifts throughout the shop that'll lift up the rapid rides or sun vans. We got the post lifts, we got the platform lifts, there's so much stuff that's behind these doors that, you know, we have our oil. When we drain our oil, it gets pumped to the back of the shop. Between each bay, there's reels there that you can pump antifreeze, the oil that you're using in the bus, the transmission fluid. We have all that in these reels right here. It comes all the way from the back of the shop. We have the grease in that far reel right there, the grease and the differential fluid. On here we have antifreeze coming through here, transmission fluid here, and these three we have oil. This is an expensive process to run this, but I mean, it's got to be done. It's either going to be done in-house or it's going to be done, we send it out, and it's going to cost the public a lot more money to send it out somewhere. As long as that bus is moving out on the road, if it picks up no passengers at all, we still put miles on it. And we're assuming that it's going to pick up people every day, you know, which it does. I mean, it picks up a lot of people. So we're still putting miles on it. We do the preventive maintenance. We're doing this for the public, so, you know, we have less road calls and less downtime, and, you know, we just try to keep the fleet going. Like I say, the buses will come in, and then we have another one that's out on the road that needs to come in for a PM. If there's nothing to work on, we'll take one of the repaired buses out and take another bus out a route while the bus, you know, still we don't have no downtime. I'm not sure, the filter was changed. I'm not sure if you look at the readout on the computer.
No, like I said, I drove it, I got light to come on, and that was it.
Yeah, well, I ended up clearing the code. I drove it up the hill, up 9 Mile Hill. I came back down, and I had the code again. So then I tracked it down to the sensor, the crankcase pressure sensor, and I changed that out, and I cleared the codes again, ran for a ride again, and the code came back again.
I drove it all the way up the hill. It didn't come on until we got right there.
But yeah. Yeah, the light didn't come back on, but it did have a code in the laptop. But the dash lights never came back on. So I just was reading it off of when I came back and read the laptop.
All righty.
And on this bus here, what we did here, we take it out for a test drive to see what's wrong with it. And we have a laptop that we take with us and plug it into the bus. And as we drive it around, put miles on it, and check it, try to duplicate the problem that it had. And in this case, we came up with a problem that's showing a component on the engine that's supposedly plugged up. So now we gotta go back in there, but we read the history, what was done to this bus. Somebody else may have worked on it previously, and this one had a filter that was changed, the crankcase breather filter, it was changed probably about a month and a half ago. So now we gotta go back in, did that filter plug up again? It shouldn't have in that shorter time. If it did, then there's something wrong with the engine. We got to go into the engine and inspect it a little bit deeper. So now the swing shift guys take over. My shift is just about over. The swing shift guys come and take over from what we leave on the computer, and he takes on from here and tries to do his best on troubleshooting problems from there. Now we got the center axle, the shocks and shocks are right here, the brake components, slack adjusters. We look further in here, and we got that of the brake shoes, which we were cutting earlier in the other shop a while ago. We're dedicated to keep the public going. You know, we got to keep the public going, and that's what we look forward to. And it's not just a job, we look forward to it. You know I do, I look forward to, you know, even on my days off and stuff, and oh yeah, I worked on that van, oh I worked on that bus, I'm happy to see it out there. You know, you see a van out there, you just worked on a wheelchair lift, and they're using that wheelchair lift to pick up a handicapped person. You're happy you were able to contribute to that. After all said and done, here's where I end my day, at the time clock. Till another day. All this stuff here is, you know, just my pen where I can jot down notes where I'm going to go for the road call. Little pocket screwdriver that comes in handy pretty much. The other side, I got a ruler, to, you know, a handy ruler that we don't have to keep a measuring tape with you. A little tablet, and my, of course, my glasses. As I'm getting older, it's harder to see here.